वाई वी शुड नॉट कट आवर हेयर और नेल्स आउटसाइड द हाउस. सो देर इज़ अ प्रैक्टिस राइट, वेन एवर यू गो आउटसाइड द हाउस और कोम्ब और कट नेल्स, यूजली यूर ग्रैंड मदर और यूर एल्डर्स माइट से डोंट कट इट आउटसाइड and they might not give you a reason, they might say like some negative things might happen, don't do it or something. But what is the meaning? Is there any real meaning behind it? Because today we all are going out and we are doing that because we are going to a saloon or a spa to do our hairdressing and styling, and then we come back. The reason why they said is, one common sense is, your hair and your nails are the parts in your body that takes longer time to decay. So that means it has a copy of your DNA in it. And in one of the movie, actually I saw very long time ago, 20 years back, a movie called as Artificial Intelligence by Steven Spielberg. It's a very good movie. I would highly recommend everyone to watch it in your free time, where a robotic person, a boy would have missed his mother, and he would have woke up after like thousands of years. So finally, the advanced robotic people would say, you are our father, you are the first robotic, and we really want to help you. He says, no, I want to be with my mother. That is the first robot that starts loving. So they will say, do you have anything from your mother where we can recreate those things, so that we can recreate your mother from human being, because there is no human being right now on the earth. And finally, he would remember that he has a hair of his mother, and they'll take the hair and they'll recreate the mother for him for a one day experience. It's a very emotional movie. But coming back to the subject, so these hair and nails do have a copy of it, and people, whoever has possession of this with any bad intention, they can definitely use this. This is one of the primary tool to influence you, even when you are here. And if I have a hair with you, and many people can actually manipulate you. Again, these are all temporary, it's not permanently they can manipulate you, but it does have an effect on it. That is why in the old movies you will say, no, bring his sand under the foot or cut his hair, we will do black magic on him. There are ways to do it, but how to do it and how many people really do it is a questionable fact in today's world. But it does have certain things. Another point is, when you keep these things outside, those parts, that hair or the nails, will have certain connections with your body, a psychic connection which you can't see in physical space. So anything harm happening to that or anything influencing that will also have a minimal influence on your mind. You might have a disturbed sleep, or somebody might burn that hair. That is actually you're burning your body, because it's a copy. Usually you burn your body when you're dead, right? It's like insulting your body or burning all those things. So never burn your hair or nails. And when you cut all these things, properly collect it and bury it outside where nobody touches that place, and no other human being with bad intention touches that place, or where dogs come and sniff it or anything they do. Because dog would sniff men, it has a capacity to observe many energies, and it will sniff it on here also. Usually in the southwest corner of your house, you can dig a pit and you can put it inside and bury it, and allow the nature to take over. Once you give it to the mother nature, you bury it, nature will take over. You don't have to worry about it, and don't burn it. This is like you are reducing your soul life. Every time you burn these, your own body parts, it will reduce you, or it might make your body a little bit weak emotionally. You might have a disturbed sleep, or it will reduce your lifetime. Because we don't have a statistical data to tell you that this person has cut hair this much, this was his lifetime. We don't have the tool or apparatus to tell the lifetime of a person, because you are influenced by your own cause and effect. But it does have influence on it. That is why they say, don't go and do it outside, because one or two hairs will fall, somebody will stamp over with bad intention, or anything might happen and you might have a disturbed reaction. Have you ever wondered that when you were normal and suddenly you react to a situation in an abnormal way, but then after some time you come to sense and you will tell the next person, I don't know why I reacted that way, I feel like it's not me who was talking, it felt like I'm not that person. But you would have repented it, or you would have felt about it later point of life. Maybe it could be a serious decision making. Always remember, these are small minute things we might miss out in life that has a deeper impact on us. So make sure you cut your hair or your nails, collect it properly and dispose it off where nobody touches or hinder those your body parts. It's actually your extension of your body's hair through which you observe the subtle energy, the cosmic, or intuition becomes sharper with the extension of hair. Now coming to the other side of the story, we don't know how to cut our hair. We go to a barber shop or a saloon or a spa there. So what they usually do is they collect it all together and they actually pack it and they actually sell it to pharmaceuticals or they sell it for the cosmetic manufacturers. In fact, many hair is one of the ingredients they use certain medicines to make. And that is a sad thing. That is why we also reap the benefit of those things. Ideally, when you cut in those days, when you want to cut a hair, in the village, there will be one person who is specialist. So they will call him to the house. So that guy would come to your house early morning. He will come like 5, 6 o'clock. He will come and they will ask you and they will take that guy to the back side of the house. Every house has a backyard. Usually we stayed near the water body. So there he will do all the cutting and dressing for you. And then you will be and he will leave everything there and he will go off. And he will take bath in the water body there and he will go off. That is the way we did it. In today's world, it is very expensive if you want to call a dresser in your house. So I'm not sure if anybody can even do that. But if you have to do it when you go out and when they do it, they have to collect it and make sure they dispose it off. I don't know how many people sell it to pharmaceutical or what happens. It is something, it is out of our control. If it is possible, try it. I am not able to do it, so I can't really comment on that area. But at least in your house when you do this, make sure you collect those things and properly you dispose it off. So that is the reason behind why our ancestors have insisted that you should not go out and do all those things. I hope that gives you clarification. In case you have a different perspective on what you have heard, or I would encourage you to take these kinds of small subjects. Talk to your elder people, like old granny sitting there, or talk to them. They will give you a very unique point of view. Maybe they don't know the scientific meaning, but your common sense is very sharp. So you can use it and connect the dots very easily. Do try it. I'm really happy the way the discussions are happening in our group and how people are seeing a video and they're reacting to it. Earlier, I used to write a long post, but now I think video is a lot more easier. I can just switch off the camera and talk rather than sitting and typing typo errors, grammatical errors. So many things I have to verify. At least here I can talk. Though I would still say I'm not talking in my natural flow because I'm alone handling everything. So when I'm talking to you, I have to check whether the fan next to me is switched off, the speaker is switched off, mobile is switched off, AC is switched off, is the memory right, timing is right. So many things I have to run. So still I'm not getting my natural flow, but eventually I will get there. But do leave your comments and any topics that you want to hear from us, when we will definitely work on it, and because we are always eager to learn. That's all I have, and I'll see you in another interesting video. Bye.